Good morning. Thank you for tuning in to St. James AME Live. I'm Reverend A.J. Davis, Senior Pastor here at St. James AME Church. Thank you for tuning in.
Like
Let's get into the word. I would like to invite your attention to the gospel according to Matthew chapter 20, verses 20 through 23. Hear the words of the Lord. Then the mother of Zebedee's sons came to Jesus with her sons, and kneeling down asked a favor of him. What is it you want? He asked, she said, grant that one of these two sons of mine may sit at your right and the other at your left in your kingdom. You don't know what you're asking, Jesus said to them. Can you drink the cup I am going to drink? We can, they answered. Jesus said to them, you will indeed drink from my cup, but to sit at my right or left is not for me to grant. These places belong to those for whom they have been prepared by my Father. I would like to tag this text this morning with the subject, Mothers on the Job. Let us pray. Eternal God, our Father, thank you once again for another opportunity to proclaim your word. I pray now, God, that you will bless this word as it goes forth. Bless those who will receive it this morning. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Someone wrote, Mother's Day is traditionally the day when children give something back to their mothers for all the spit they produce to wash dirty faces, and all the gum they held in their hands, all the noses that they wiped, and all the bloody knees that made well with their kisses. This is the day mothers are rewarded for washing sheets in the middle of the night, driving kids to school when they miss their bus, and enduring all those football and soccer games in the rain. It's a day of appreciation for making your children finish something they said they could not do, not believing them when they said, I hate you, and sharing their good times and their bad times. What are mothers? Good question. Well, mothers are teachers. Mothers are disciplinarians. Mothers are cleaning ladies. Mothers are gardeners and mowers of lawns. Mothers are nurses and doctors and psychologists and counselors and chauffeurs and coaches. Mothers are developers of personalities, molders of vocabularies, and shapers of attitudes. Mothers are soft voices saying, I love you. And mothers are a link to God, a child's first impression of God's love. Mothers are all these things and much, much more. One of my favorite columns by the late Irma Louise Bombeck, who died April 22, 1996, after writing over 4,000 newspaper columns, tells of God in the act of creating mothers. She says that on the day God created mothers, he had already worked long overtime, and an angel said to him, Lord, you sure are spending a lot of time on this one. The Lord turned and said, have you read the specs on this model? She is supposed to be completely washable, but not plastic. She is to have 180 moving parts, all of them replaceable. She is to have a kiss that will heal everything from a broken leg to a broken heart. She is to have a lap that will disappear whenever she stands up. She is to be able to function on black coffee and leftovers. And she is supposed to have six pairs of hands. Six pairs of hands, she said the angel. That's impossible. It's not the six pairs of hands that bother me, said the Lord. It's the three pairs of eyes. She's supposed to have one pair that sees through closed doors so that whenever she says, what are you kids doing in there? She already knows what they're doing in there. She has another pair in the back of her head to see all the things she's not supposed to see but must see. And then she has one pair right in front that can look at a child that just goofed and communicate love and understanding without even saying a word. That's too much, said the angel. You can't put that much in one model. Why don't you rest for a while and resume your creating tomorrow? No, I can't, said the Lord. I'm close to creating someone very much like myself. I've already come up with a model who can heal herself when she is sick. Who can feed a family of six with 1 pound of hamburger? Who can persuade a 9-year-old to take a shower? Then the angel looked at the model of motherhood a little more closely and said, she's too soft. Oh, but she is tough, said the Lord. You'd be surprised at how much this mother can do. Can she think, asked the angel. Not only can she think, said the Lord, but she can reason and compromise and persuade. Then the angel reached over and touched her cheek. This one has a leak, he said. I told you that you couldn't put that much in one model. That's not a leak, said the Lord. That's a tear. What's a tear for, asked the angel. Well, it's for joy, it's for sadness, for sorrow, for disappointment, for pride. You're a genius, said the angel, and the Lord said, oh, but I didn't put it there. Maybe with all this in mind, we can better understand Mrs. Zebedee, the mother of James and John. Mrs. Zebedee was aware of the teachings of Jesus about his kingdom. She was also very aware of the fact that her sons, James and John, were close to him. They were two-thirds of the inner circle of Peter, James, and John. So she was certain that when the Lord formed his kingdom, that they would have positions of responsibility and authority. But in the first part of this same chapter, Jesus tells a story that must have disturbed her. It was a story about a landowner who went out to find laborers early in the morning. They agreed upon a fair day's wage and started working. And then at the noon day hour, he went out and found some more, and they started working. Then towards evening, he went out and found some more, and they started working. Yet when the Lord paid them off at the end of the day, they all received the same wage. It must have caused Mrs. Zebedee to wonder, will my sons really have positions of authority in the Lord's new kingdom? So when the opportunity presented itself, she came to the Lord. Matthew says that she bowed before him and made this request. When you establish your kingdom, please let my son sit in places of authority and honor on your right and left hand. We might very well criticize Mrs. Zebedee for her presumptuousness, but since today is Mother's Day, maybe we ought to think for a few moments concerning some positive things about Mrs. Zebedee. We need to also to recognize that when she came to Jesus, while Jesus did not grant her request, neither did he deny it. He simply reminded her of the cost of being seated on the right or left and told her that it is the Father who determines who will be seated there. Talk about mothers on the job today. First of all, she prayed that her sons might be a part of his kingdom. Now, what are some of the good things about Mrs. Zebedee? First of all, she came to the Lord, praying that her sons might be a part of his kingdom. And I can think of no more important task of motherhood than that to seek to ensure that your children are a part of the kingdom of God. I know that many mothers pray. Sometimes they pray out of necessity. Sometimes they pray because motherhood is not easy, but extremely difficult. A pastor tells about a time he came home with his son, who was a small baby. It had been a terrible day for his wife. The son had been sick and had cried all day long. And once, as the mother was changing his diapers, the telephone rang, and the mother reached over to answer it before fastening up his diaper. And just then, the baby had another attack of diarrhea. The mother cleaned up that mess and put the son in clean, sweet, smelling clothes. And then she took him into the living room and fed him. And as she was burping him, he threw up all over himself and her and the couch too. Pastor wrote, when I came home, I could smell the aroma of motherhood everywhere. And the mother cried out to him, was all of this in my contract? Sometimes mothers pray just out of the frustration of it all. And sometimes in the frustration of trying to teach their children, they realize the difficulties of communication. Story is told about a father remembers very clearly the time he gave his 2-year-old son, Junior, his very first responsibility. He told Junior to watch his baby sister while he stepped out of the room. He had only been gone a few moments when he heard a thump, and then his baby sister started crying. He rushed back in to find that baby girl had fallen from the couch and was stretched out on the floor. And meanwhile, Junior sat there like a deer in headlights, looking so innocent. And the father said, "Junior, I told you to watch her." Junior answered, "I did. I watched her fall, and I watched her cry. And I did exactly what I was told to do, watch her." Being a parent is not easy. Sometimes you're filled with joy, and sometimes you're filled with sadness. Sometimes your children make you so proud you want to pop your buttons. At the other times, you can't find enough handkerchiefs to dry your tears. And I can understand the feelings of the mother with three children who was asked, "If you had it all to do over again, would you have children?" "Yes," she replied, "but not the same ones." Being a parent is not easy. It is difficult. But Mrs. Zebedee gives us a valuable example, for she prayed earnestly that her sons would be a part of the Lord's kingdom. We need that same concern for our children. What good is it if our children are successful in making money, driving fine automobiles, and living in good neighborhoods, but they don't know God? What does it matter if they gain the whole world but lose their souls? I hope that in the heart of every mother and father here listening to me this morning, there is a burden to go to the throne of God and to pray for your children, to pray that they will be saved from eternal damnation and for eternal life. This is the place to begin. Not only that, but secondly, she prayed that her sons would be actively involved in the work of his kingdom. Not only that, but she prayed that they would be involved in the work of the kingdom. Maybe it's not enough just to be saved. Churches are full of people content just to fill a pew on Sunday mornings. There are plenty of people willing to sit back and receive the blessings, but seldom do they get involved in doing any of the real work of the church. But where does the spirit of service begin? It begins at home, with mothers and fathers setting the example and praying that their sons and their daughters might be involved in the work of the kingdom as teachers and leaders, disciplining others that they might be the ones to go out into the world and find the lost, to see that the church continues on until Jesus comes again. Mrs. Zebedee prayed that her children would be actively involved in the work of his kingdom. And we need to walk in her footsteps too. Not only that, thirdly, Mrs. Zebedee had big expectations. When you're working in a kingdom, there are no higher positions than those on the right and left of the king himself. And that's what she wanted for her sons. She didn't just pray that her children would be doorkeepers. She wanted them on the right and left hand of Jesus. We may consider Mrs. Zebedee brash and presumptuous, but I admire her boldness. Too often people have settled for mediocrity in the church. For too long, some have been content with just barely making it through the door. Far too long, they have been content to sit back and let things happen. It is time for some of us to take our positions on the right and left hand to become leaders, molding and fashioning the outreach of the church, mobilizing to make sure the message of Jesus Christ goes into all the world. It is time, beloved, to strive for excellence, to reach for the very best there is. Lord calls us to be his disciples and to be effective laborers in his kingdom. Do you remember Irma Bombat? Had God saying as he was created, "Mother, I am close to creating something very much like myself"? I suppose that is why today is special, because we recognize that mother's love is probably the closest example we have to God's love. It is a love that goes through the valley of the shadow of death to bring life into being. It is a love that sacrifices itself over and over and over again and would even dare to lay down its life for its own offspring. Mothers, this is your day. May God bless you in it. And I pray that if there is someone here out there who has never experienced the love of God, that is so close to the love of a mother, that this will be your time of decision And I pray that if you have felt that you have had to walk through that valley alone so many times, that you will recognize that there is a hand reaching out to you saying, there is nothing to be afraid of. I will go with you. And I pray that you will recognize that there is one who has already gone through the valley of the shadow of death for you and made it possible for you to live forever. Today he extends his loving invitation in much the same that way that a mother go open the doors of her home and calls her children in. He calls you too, beloved, and I pray that you will come as we go out and continue to bless this country with the word of God. For those of you who do not know him, that you will get to know him, because that will be the best decision that you could ever make, because he will make you a brand new creature. May God bless you, and may he keep you as our prayer. Be blessed with these words, and be safe. Thank you for tuning in to St. James AME Live. I am Reverend A.J. Davis, Senior Pastor at St. James AME Church here in the city of Titusville. We are so excited about what the Lord is doing here at St. James. Even in the midst of the storm, we will continue to be a light in our community. I'm inviting you to start your week off right by attending our Sunday worship service at 10 a.m. via Facebook, YouTube, our website, and our conference line. We also offer an interactive Bible discovery hour for youth of all ages on Sundays at 11 a.m. via Zoom. Bible study is held via conference call on Wednesdays at 12 p.m. and again on Thursdays at 6 p.m. On Tuesdays, I host a corporate prayer line at 6 o'clock p.m. via our conference line. To join, dial 321-245-6928. If you're in need of prayer or desire to join this body of Christ, please visit our website at www.stjamesametitusville.org and click for prayer or to become a member. Finally, we offer a convenient way for you to participate in the worship of giving. Give of your tithes and offerings. You can visit our website and click online giving, or you may text the work give to 321-323-3898. Keep up with the latest here at St. James. Join a mailing list on our website and follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. We pray that you stay encouraged during this time, and most of all, stand on the promises of God. Thank you for tuning in. See you online very soon.